she gon' go just like Diego. God. Yeah, they don't play with me cause they know that I'm on go, no Diego.
Why you think we're the same? We ain't the same. I'm the type to do the hitting up. You the type to pay hitters.
It's the National Football. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Kansas City. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Here is Tua Tagovailoa heading out to lead this Miami offense.
Every time he leads his team out, there's no questioning he's put the work in to earn his place in the NFL. There's no shortage of stories we've heard throughout his career about the effort he puts in to be in this spot. And that motivates everybody on his team.
It'll go as a loss of 3 right away, and it's second down.
All right, come on.
Sometimes you get all those big guys down there in one spot and there's just nowhere to go. And in this case, the defensive tackle used his strength and swallowed him up.
Now the pressure gets there and Tua is going to be taken down. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. There's the former Chief, man they watched for years, Tyreek Hill. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. On first and 10, it's Mostert. And he'll be taken down at about the 45.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
And that's exactly what defenses talk about. You've got to find ways to get off the field when you can, especially on third down. And third down defense going to be vital in this game. Able to knock that one away and force a fourth down.
And this one hits at the 1, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. Time to see what Patrick Mahomes can do here with his first possession. The quarterback out of Texas Tech getting set to lead this KC Chiefs offense.
And simply put, for many, he's the gold standard for quarterbacks in today's NFL because of his ability to create, find the open man, use all the different arm angles that he has. He's a complete package, and boy, his team loves to play around him.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
This is part of why this guy's got multiple MVPs on the mantle. We're used to seeing him make the impossible throws, but here Mahomes knows he's got nothing, so wisely just gets rid of it.
Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield, and he'll go out near midfield at the 49. That one covers 29 yards, first down. Mahomes going to throw. That's complete. It's Travis Kelce. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 32-yard line. Throwing now is Mahomes. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And they're going to get this down inside the 15. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points no matter what. At worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting 3.
We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
Tyreek Hill, and all the way in from a Miami touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 82 yards. And the Dolphins are on the board first here on the road in Kansas City. And he showcased his blazing speed on that one.
Was he wearing football cleats or track spikes? Because he was gone. Big time play. And just think about what that does if you're a receiver on the team with him. Well, that's got to open things up for you as well, because if I'm a defense, I've got to get back deeper and deeper in order to keep him in front. But I'm not sure how many can actually keep him in front with that speed.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And able to get this out to the 25. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Looking to throw is Mahomes. That's caught left side by the tight end, Gray. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it brings up third and five now. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Mahomes now to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play. Mahomes now on first down. Open man downfield is Hardman. He's got it. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mecole Hardman, 49 yards. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from drawing level. Great corner route there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and we are tied at seven. So I'll leave it at seven now as they kick it away. This taken in right around the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Dolphins offense now ready to go back out onto the field.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Chris Jones on the stop.
Early down stuff will put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
And now the throw here is incomplete, and with that, we come to the end of the first quarter of play. 7-7, our score after one. It's Dolphins football here as we begin the second quarter. As they've got it with a third down coming up. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed one conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
Here's James returning. That'll go as a 46-yard punt with a return of seven. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. And now here comes Kansas City. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around.
So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. Here's Pacheco once again. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 2 yards, good enough for a first. Here's Mahomes to throw. Short throw hauled in by Kelce. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Second and a couple. Man open, that's Marquez Valdez-Scantling. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 27 yard line. Mahomes looking left side and he's got a man. That's Rice. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A well executed 22 yard gain. And again it's Mahomes. This is caught. Touchdown. Noah Gray. A 5 yard touchdown. And the Chiefs have taken the lead. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that makes the score 14-7. That time a 6-play drive. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Taken at the goal line. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Miami's offense set and ready to go. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. And he'll take this one up to about the 23. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. A 6-yard pickup brings up second and 4. Here's Tua. Over the middle, complete. That's Hill. And Hill is going to have the Dolphins first down as the tackle made right at the 30-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. They hand it off to Mostert. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Justin Reed, the safety, made the tackle. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. From the 33, here's a second and 7. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3, and now it's third down. Here's Tua. Oh, the ball comes out on the hip, but they'll say it's incomplete. So after 3 drives and 3 touchdowns combined between these two clubs, finally we get a defensive stop.
Yes, and welcome to the party, defensive players. And glad to have you, because for a while there, it almost felt like it was 11 going downfield on air. Okay, so to be able to have someone come up, make a stop, now we got a football game going.
Now on fourth down here, that pass knocked away. Complete. So first and 10 now from the 30. To throw, it's Mahomes. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Isaiah Pacheco, 30 yards. And the Chiefs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Butker is on target. And it's now 21-7. A nice, tidy little drive there, getting the ball in excellent field position, and only one play to score it. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. Well, Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
And going deep for Hill. He's got it. Hit the 15. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Tyreek Hill with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Dolphins are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six. What a first half he is compiling here. He's already over 100 yards receiving and now two touchdowns, CD.
Brandon, you know I don't like to play the game where you start projecting when you're at a certain point. Well, let's face it, he's off to a tremendous start. So 200 yards, four touchdowns. I don't think anything's out of the question right now. He's blowing up coverages. You got to double him every snap. Otherwise, he's going to defeat you on almost every play.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. KC's offense ready to take over. Still more than a minute to go, so you know, there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time.
Now the ball comes loose, but it looks like one of the DBs has it. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. A lot of talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it, and not realizing the danger lurks while you're doing so. And there's your end result right there.
Now Achane on first and 10. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
That's interference. Defense.
So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
On second down, Mostert. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. This now a third and four. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. The Kansas City defense tough to throw on there. Fourth down. So fourth down, two and departs, and on is Jason Sanders and the Dolphin field goal unit. Sanders' kick is good, and that'll bring him back within four. So golden field position there squandered as they can muster only a field goal.
Yeah, you were gifted a first and goal situation, but I have to give credit to the defense. They were brought out in a really tough situation, so give them credit for holding them to three. That's a pretty nice accomplishment.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Jerome Baker there on the tackle. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. Well, no sooner do the teams get to the locker rooms, and they're running right back out. Halftime over, third quarter, ready to go.
It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three.
As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well. Most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. A pass complete downfield. It's Valdez Scantling. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Marquez Valdez Scantling, 45 yards.
And the Chiefs come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. Extra point by Butker is on target.
And that pushes the lead up to 11.
Braxton Berrios selected to bring it out.
And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. So here are the Dolphins now. They get ready for their first possession of the second half.
They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a two-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive, that could make this a three-possession game.
He's going to launch this thing way downfield. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It's a big play there for Miami. 59 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Now a give to Mostert running right. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. They fake the handoff. Now Tua. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect him to have more completions to him in this game.
From the gun, it's Tua. Touchdown, Dolphins! Braxton Berrios from 6 yards away.
And the Dolphins have got it back to within a score. So a strong drive here to lead off this third quarter and gets them right back in this football game.
And I think we can safely call that a statement drive, because they had to be saying, we didn't put our best foot forward in the first half, but we certainly mean business now. Maybe a better term, a prove-it drive. They proved it to themselves that they were ready to go.
Mike McDaniel, no hesitation on his end. He's telling his offense to go for two. The two are going to try and throw for it.
And no, it falls incomplete. So the two-point conversion, no good.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
Another drive coming for KC, and we'll see Marquez Valdes-Scantling once again.
Pretty good game for him so far. I guess he's still got time here to make this a great game, but so far, he's been solid.
I like where you're going with that, because it has been pretty good, but there's always that hint that things can really escalate for him. And right now, they feel like they're somewhat keeping him in check, but he has found the end zone once, but boy, he can explode at any moment.
Yeah, and when you hit that end zone once, you want to find it again, don't you?
Yes, you do.
You get hungrier.
You get greedy in a good way.
Powering forward, and he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. A gain there of 21 yards. From midfield, here's Mahomes. That ball caught, it's Rice. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they pull over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
Second and six.
Now Mahomes. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That's a pretty play there. Got in at the last second, helped force the ball free, and kept them out of the end zone.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on third down, forcing the errant pass. Fourth down coming up.
Play action supposed to be used to slow down pressure, slow down blitzes. In this case, though, if it takes a little too long to develop, you got people right in your face.
And lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble. Butker's kick here is good. And that'll push the lead up to eight. So a nice kick there as they are able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Miami set to take over. They couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game. First and 10 here. They'll start on the ground with Mostert.
And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line.
Stopped and handed a loss by Willie Gay that time.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Now Tua. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yes, let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
On third down, Achane.
And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Well, they certainly didn't appear to be fired up about their options throwing the football. So, to me, this seems like a case of just kind of taking their medicine there, run the ball, see if they could pick up something. Instead, they were throwing for a loss.
And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown! Tyreek Hill, 84 yards.
And the Dolphins are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter.
That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
Sanders now to add the extra point. And this is now a one-point game. A drive there of just four plays.
And it ends with a touchdown pass to Tyreek Hill. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. So both offenses come to life here in this third quarter. We're back now in KC. And we've got a dandy here. A one-point game as we begin the fourth. On first down, Mahomes. Over the middle, that's caught by Rice. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Running left to give to Pacheco. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. Quick throw caught out wide by Valdez-Scantling. Down the right sideline. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Marquez Valdez-Scantling. With his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chiefs are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one possession game, down eight. They'll be looking for the touchdown and two-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. This one complete to Jalen Waddle. And he'll be dropped just shy of the 35 at the 34. A pickup of 17 on a play that originated at the 17. This is Mostert. He'll work his way up the middle for a gain of about four, second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
From the 37, they work on second and six. Tua gonna throw. And his throw is incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. And going deep for Hill. And he's got it inside the 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
First and goal, a touchdown and a two-point conversion here are musts. Mostert, oh, he's going absolutely nowhere as he is hit behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. Second and goal from the six this time. Looking to pass, Tua. Touchdown, Dolphins! Tua fighting his old Alabama teammate, Jalen Waddle. And the Dolphins have a chance to tie things up as they trail by two here in the fourth. So part one of what they needed is done. They get in the end zone. Now you have to imagine we'll see a try for two.
And that's what the book says, but defensively, they can't hang their head right here. They still got a chance to come out with the lead if they make a play.
On a bad time late for a poor throw, it's intercepted.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass
gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you got a chance to take it all the way back at 10 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case here, but you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. Well, good looking return setup here. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Drive coming for KC, and we'll see Marquez Valdes-Scantling once again.
When you're in a zone like he is, what's the conversation like on the sideline between he and his quarterback? Is that a one-way conversation of, hey, just keep getting me the football?
It actually is probably a two-way conversation because he wants to keep getting him the football because he's seeing the payoff. You know, getting the ball to that guy means yardage and, as we've seen, touchdowns in this game. So I think both of them get more and more excited about the possibilities as things continue on.
Yeah, so far it's been over 100 yards and the two scores.
A run by Pacheco on second down. And that's going to be a Chiefs first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine.
Not a lot of running room there, not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
Again, it's Pacheco,
and nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining.
On third down, it's Pacheco,
and they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline.
So Tua and the Dolphins down by two, 23 seconds to go. Needing at least 40 yards, you'd have to think, to have a shot. Here's Tua.
And he completes it to Berrios. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside.
This offense cannot stop the clock now. No timeouts remaining as they come up here first down. Tua.
That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line.
What a game we were treated to in this one. And on that final play, they had a chance. They had the ball just beyond midfield. One final shot, but couldn't get it done, and they suffered a loss.
Yeah, and you